All right. Hey, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Mission Impact Series with Ty and Tracy. And today we're talking about the six areas of your mid-level, your mid-year assessment. So if you've been joining us, the first part was, why do you need the mid-year assessment? The second one we did was preparing for a quality assessment. So you do need to go out and watch those before you watch this. Watch the entire series so that you can get a better understanding of what we're talking about. So again, like I said, we're talking about the six areas of assessing your business during the mid-year assessment. My name is Tracy V. Allen. I am the owner of TVA Consulting Group. I help change agents to design, build, and fund their social enterprise ventures, maximize their revenue, and impact their communities. I've been in this business for over 20 years. I'm really old, you guys. make sure to click the like button, share button, leave a comment below, and turn on your notifications so you know when we upload videos every week.
All right, my name is Ty Boone. I'm owner of Ty Boone Enterprises. Like Tracy, I've been in this business for over 20 years. So together we're killing this, man, right? Together. I help mostly nonprofit organizations move from startup and struggle to sustainability and success. Some of that sustainability requires assessment, right? All this stuff kind of goes together. It's like even assessing your ability to sustain. Like how we know we're going to make it? Like, how do we know we're going to make it to the next thing? I'm a programs girl. So I think, and we're talking about, you know, six different areas of assessments. I'm a programs girl. And I think number one, you know, at the top is being able to assess, you know, your mission, your strategy, and knowing how to properly evaluate your programs, whether or not that's lining up with what your mission is about. Because sometimes we get off mission. Tracy, this is Mission Impact, and I remember when we first started doing the podcast, we had a whole thing about mission and mission drift, and it was like, oh yeah, this is serious, because what people think is easy or think kind of take lightly on the outside, like, yeah, I got a mission statement, cool, whatever, but not even taking them a moment to step back and say, hey, is what we're doing really in line with our mission, what we said we're going to do? So your mission is what you're doing right now, your vision is what do in the future. So are we doing things right now that's going to take us to that future place of our vision, and being able to step back and to properly assess that? So what do our numbers look like? Who are we reaching out to? Are we doing transformational stuff instead of transactional stuff? And is our transactional stuff leading to some type of transformation? What are we doing in the middle? So that programmatic piece, number one. And I'm going to also add, and I'm going to let you go. leadership is another area, to take a look at. Leadership, staffing, volunteers. Mm-hmm. Are people working out? If not, can we? 6 months is enough. You know it. When you're in a relationship with anybody, you know it in about 2 weeks, whether or not this is going to be, everybody can be nice to you for 2.5 weeks. Gonna have some kind of flag or something gonna show up, something's going on. Is this what we're wanting to do for the long term? How is the leadership working out? Is your staff helping you to meet your mission and accomplish those goals that you set out for your organization? Doing this stuff, and I know you're like, okay, I've had these people that work with me for 5 years, my board's been here for whatever. Still taking the time mid-year to step back and say, hey, are we going toward this mission? Are we meeting this mission that we're needing to meet with this team that we have in place?
Right. I totally agree with all that you said. And I'll just add for staff, when you're looking at your staff, even at your board members, right? You have to look at it as from a financial aspect, right? Because everybody on your team is there to help you to generate revenue. You're not just there to pay people. Their job, whether you know it or not, the person that you work for, your job is to help them make more money. So if what they're doing or their role in your business is actually sucking money from you and not replacing what they're being paid, then you may need to look at whether or not this person is the right fit for your business. Mm-hmm. Right? So board members, when board members sit on a board, part of their job is to raise money. So if you have a board member who has never donated a dollar, has never brought in a dollar, what is this person's real role on your business, on your board? You may need to replace that person based on your bylaws. I want to say that. Replace that person with someone who's going to be more proactive and about getting, you know, either awareness to your mission and vision or getting funds to come in. You know, there are different roles that they can play, but their job is to bring money in. The same thing with your staff. You know, if you have a staff member who is constantly making mistakes and maybe you have to constantly file claims with your insurance company, then this staff member is not the right person for your business because they're costing you more money than they're actually helping you to generate. They're there. The person who answers the phone, whatever it is, that answering the phone is helping you to generate revenue. If that person is nice, they understand the business and can convey your mission to the person that they're talking to, they're an asset that's helping you to generate more money.
I told somebody the other day, they were like, I'm going to have a board. They were complaining that the board wouldn't do anything, right? It's like, I'm going to have a board retreat and I'm going to do it. I was like, why are you having a board retreat? You got to pay for that. They ain't doing nothing. You got to.
Right.
Why are you feeding them and giving them free stuff? Why they got to go to the cabins and they ain't doing the work?
Right.
Why are you treating them? Y'all need a meeting.
It has to make sense, right? It has to make financial sense. Mm-hmm. And that's the next thing. The one thing that you do want to make sure you assess is your finances. Mm-hmm. How much money are you bringing in? How much positive cash flow do you have? Assessing, and we've talked about this in previous lives where we talked about assessing your profit and loss. How much money are you spending in maintaining the business versus how much money are you bringing into the business? That has to balance off. If your overhead is higher than the revenue you're bringing in, then you're really not doing business. You're operating in a loss, right? So soon from now, you're going to have to shut your business down. So you really want to think about when you're doing your mid-level assessment, if you said you wanted to make $500,000 for the year, at this point in the business, you should be at $250,000. Mm-hmm. And if you're not at $250,000, you have got to dissect your business. Think about when you were in high school and you were doing the frog dissection in lab class, right? Or the cats. Oh, anyways, I took the frog any day over the cats. You're truly going to have to dissect your business to find out where the leak is. Mm-hmm. There's a leak in your marketing. There's a leak in your promotions. There is a leak in your product offerings. There may be a leak, like I said, with somebody on your staff who's driving people away, because I know if I interact with a business and I get a rude response from one person, I'm probably not going to go back and use that person's services. So you need to dissect the business and figure out where the leak are. So why you're not meeting your benchmarks. Mm-hmm. So when we talk about six areas, we're talking about financial. Ty talked about programs. We're talking about customers, right? You know, you should be doing customer service. What do you call it? Customer service surveys to find out what your customers liked or didn't like about your service so you can improve so you don't have those leaks. We're talking about your staff. Remember, your staff is an integral part of you being able to make money in the business. Their job is to help you generate revenue. Mm-hmm. I don't know why people don't understand that. I have to keep saying that. Their job.
Because you're talking, so they gotta bring in more. It's whatever. Everything that you do, if getting money is about you, you have to. That's what you have to do. I talk about that when I tell people about fundraising. I'm like, if you have something fundraising, everything that you think about in this fundraising plan should equal money, because you're trying to raise. If I'm working, I can't hire a whole bunch of people to work for me and we don't make no money because they making money and I ain't making none.
Right.
And that ain't how we do this over here.
Absolutely not. Right? Yeah, like I said, you have to assess your marketing. Mm-hmm. Is your marketing working? You know, if you're spending money on ads or you're putting up posts all the time, you're not getting engagement or you're not converting any of that engagement into actual paid clients. That's something else you need to assess and figure out how you're going to fix it. And the last one is our favorite one, right? That we talk about all the time, because nothing else works without this part, is the partnerships, right? You have to assess your partnerships. Are they working for you? Are they working? And again, everybody's in this game to do what? Awareness, right? And money.
And money, right?
And those are the things.
The partners that work.
Awareness and money.
Together, you know, knowing, being able to know, assess the level of awareness that you're providing to about your organization. We don't think about that. And it's not just the Facebook post or Instagram thing. If you're in the social impact business, people should know you.
Yes.
In the community. You've seen these little community award things, like hamburger helpers, like, you know, and people are like, okay, you nominate my, anybody know your organization? We're not going over here voting for you. But right. If you're out there being visible, whether I have a one-on-one connection with you or not, if you're out here being visible, something about your logo, something about your name is gonna stick here. That's psychology, right? I'm like, I think I saw somebody giving out water bottles over there in the corner, and it may have been an organization. So I saw, let me put in a vote for them. Like, I don't even know part of the thing, but I'm visible. Mm-hmm. You know, like, even if, you know, COVID kind of put a wrench into people doing outreach and stuff, but you're talking about a whole year where people couldn't go out, but then you have and instead of folk using that to their advantage, they just went to sleep on it, right? Mm-hmm. There's absolutely no reason why you shouldn't have been all over social media, because you couldn't go anywhere else.
Right.
You couldn't go anywhere else with your business except for social media when COVID crept up on the scene. So right now, and you know, Tracy, even I was doing some grant reviews last week or whatever it was. And one of the things that concerns the grant reviewers were, you know what? I understand that COVID was here, but their social media should have been popping 2020. You know, at least at the beginning of 2021, when they figured out, hey, we're going to just be here. And I went to their social media page, and they hadn't made a post since January. Mm-hmm. But they're asking for money. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, how are you raising awareness about your cause? How are you promoting? How are you marketing?
Right.
Stop 6 months right now. It's where, you know, stop right now and say, hey, what did I look like for the past 6 months? Do I need to get out and get more visible?
Yeah. All right. I think that's it. I'll just run down the list one more time so that you got it. For those of you who didn't get it to begin with, it's financial, programs, customers, staff, marketing, and partnerships. Those are the six areas that you truly need to assess. Of course, you're going to have subtopics under each one of those, but those are the areas that you really need to assess. All right, guys, until next time, remember to like, share, subscribe, and put on your notification bells. Bye.